I'm going to show you a really easy way to use Google Sheets to create charts or graphs so you can kind of visualize your data a little easier. So first you have to have a sheet and some headings. So I have my fake student list here and then some fake data. So maybe this is like a grade book or something like that. And here's my students and then I've got my data inputted. So all I need to do to start a chart or a graph, click on the data. So I'm going to click and drag. So I'm going to select all of the data I want to make a chart with. So it's all this blue highlighted color right now. And there's a couple places you can look. Down here at the bottom, there's an explore button. You can click that and it quickly gives you some ideas of charts you can use. I kind of go old school. I like the options of going up to the insert button up here and going down to chart, but either one you can find the same things. They'll do the same thing. So I'm gonna click the chart button. It's gonna dump a chart in here that I can see. Now it's small and I'll make it bigger, but this is just the basic thing that Sheets said. I think this is what you're trying to do. I can change my chart style by going over here where it says chart type and clicking that drop down, and I can kind of see. Now these are the four that were suggested. I could choose, like maybe this was a like a timeline chart or something like that. It chose the best chart for that data. And in this case, this is the kind of chart I would use, but there are other options. You could do it a stacked one where it takes all of your scores and puts them on top of each other. So maybe all of those four pieces of data were really going to accumulate to be one final score. There's also, and this won't work necessarily, but there are pie charts. This is obviously not the kind of data I would use with that, but you can choose which one you want. Maybe you want a horizontal type chart. I'm going to go ahead and stick with that original one right here. So that gives me my basic chart. I'll make it a little bit bigger so we can see it a little bit better. And I can kind of move it around for right now. But this is pretty boring. It's just right out of the bat, this is what it decided to make. If I go up here to the top where it says customize over here on the right, this is where you get to kind of change your chart to make it what you want it to be. And you can work your way down all of these topics and kind of click and choose what you want. I tend to go with 3D. It makes it a little bolder and shows up a little bit better. And then you can go down to the axis and you can name these things. Like maybe I just want this to be scores. And when I click into it, you can see right over here, it just changed that chart title to scores. If you want to have more room, you can always take off the title as well, and it kind of jumps the chart up a little bit more. You can bold things, change the text a little bit, format things the way you want. Maybe I want my labels to actually have all their numbers on it. Now, this is kind of a bad one for that because there's so much data here. Those are really hard to see, so I may not want that. But you can go ahead and kind of poke around in here and see the things you want to do, all the axes. You can change all kinds of stuff. Maybe you want to put some grid lines in so that these show up a little bit more. And you can see some of those lines now appeared in the back. So there's lots of settings that you can put in here to make this chart work for you. Now, when I'm done, I can just go ahead and click the edit back off. I can move this chart out on my sheet, but if I want it kind of big enough to kind of see, I can still edit this. I can go to these three dots here and go back to edit the chart. I can delete it if I'm just like, you know what, I really don't want it. I can download this as an image or a PDF. So maybe I want to share this with someone as an image or put it in a document or something. I have that ability. I can publish it to the web. I can copy it and paste it into something else. I can also move it to its own sheet. So right now you can see it's kind of on top of all my data right here. And if I wanted to see my scores and my chart, I'd have to make it really small and suddenly it gets hard to see. So I can click those three dots, go down to move to its own sheet, and then right down here at the bottom, I've got my data where I was at here, where I made it, and my chart number one. It's a lot bigger and easier to read. And what's nice about this is as I go over it, you can see it's interactive. I can pull up the data from that student. So you can see here that all of data one, that first assessment tool, I've got all my students listed down here. That's my piece of data, and the first one for each kid is blue. I can go in and just double click on that color and I can change any of the stuff that I want to change. So maybe I don't like the colors and I don't want that first data to be blue. Maybe I did that in the start of school. And for some reason in my brain, the start of school is red. Do my fill color and change that to red. Then I can go back up to that data and go to data two. And I'm thinking this is kind of like Thanksgiving time. And I'm going to make that a orangish brown color. And data three we did during the winter time. And my brain thinks, well, that's got to be blue. And then my data four is springtime. And that's sunny and grass. So that's green. So you can change those colors however you want. And then you can see that they changed right over here as well. And there's lots of customizing you can do. It's basically just kind of jump around here and take a look, find the ones that work for you. You can't break it. You can always undo any mistake that you might make. Click the little X up here, and then I'm back to this full screen view. I go back to my full data, and then I can go back over here. And even on this page, I can go to my copy my chart, I can edit, I can publish, I can do all those same things I could do before. So once again, just edit, click the button, and you're back into this whole customized thing, and you could change however you want. Maybe make the background blue. You could do anything you want with your charts to make them work for you.